Rapper DaBaby is feeling the full extent of cancel culture following homophobic comments that were made at the Rolling Loud Music Festival in Miami. I'm Mackenzie and let's get into all the details, but first make sure to subscribe if you're new here. The comments were made on July 25th while he was performing. DaBaby paused to say, quote, "If you didn't show up today with HIV/AIDS, any of them deadly STDs, that'll make you die in 2 or 3 weeks. Put your cell phone light up." Adding that ladies can put their cell phone lights up, but their privates, quote, "smell like water." Going on to make derogatory comments about men hooking up in the parking lot. After the comments were made, the rapper faced backlash from fellow performers as well as fans. The rapper was supposed to be headlining the final day of Lollapalooza, but after the comments, the festival dropped him. The festival said in a statement, quote, "Lollapalooza was founded on diversity, inclusivity, respect, and love. With that in mind, DaBaby will no longer be performing at Grant Park tonight." Young Thug then took his place. Several artists also spoke out against the rapper's comments. The first artist I saw to speak out against DaBaby was Dua Lipa. DaBaby performs in the popular Levitating remix with her. She said that the statements horrified her, adding, quote, "I really don't recognize this as the person I worked with. I know my fans know where my heart lies and that I stand 100% with the LGBTQ community. We need to come together and fight the stigma and ignorance around HIV/AIDS. Elton John, who founded the Elton John AIDS Foundation charity in 1992, took to Instagram to condemn his statements as well, saying he was shocked and comments like this, quote, "fuel stigma and discrimination. It's the opposite of what our world needs to fight the AIDS epidemic." Chris Brown even seemed to get involved, commenting on Instagram, quote, "shut the F up, do your shows, thank everybody, then get the F off stage." Brown didn't address DaBaby by name, but it was pretty clear who he was talking about. At first, DaBaby somewhat defended his comments, saying, quote, "what I do at a live show is for the audience at the live show. It'll never translate correctly to somebody looking at a little 5-6 second clip from their goddamn crib on their phone." However, days later, he tweeted out a second apology, apologizing for the comments made against HIV/AIDS, but still seeming to deflect. The most recent festival to drop DaBaby is New York City's Governor's Ball. Just last night, the Governor's Ball tweeted out a statement condemning hate and discrimination, adding that a new lineup was coming soon. The festival did not specifically name DaBaby as the reason for the change, but he was removed from the poster that was showing their lineup. DaBaby was originally listed in the lineup that was posted May 4th. So it seems like there's no end in sight for the cancellation of DaBaby, and unless he posts a genuine apology, he'll probably still continue to get kicked from festivals. Let me know your thoughts on this one below, guys. I've personally never been a fan of DaBaby, so this really doesn't change my opinion of him. But it's interesting to see that he's getting booted from so many festivals when a lot of other artists that are performing at these festivals have also been involved in similar scandals. I think we've seen that cancel culture definitely picks and chooses who gets canceled, but I also think a lot of this would have just been avoided if he genuinely apologized for the comments like right after the fact, but you can let me know your thoughts on all that below. That's all for the video, guys. Thanks so much for sticking around. If you made it all the way here, if you liked the video, and if you want to see some more, make sure to like and subscribe to the channel below. I've been your host, Mackenzie Smith. Make sure to check us out on social media, and I'll catch you all in the next one.